we will do the cosmic sound meditation. It's called cosmic sound meditation. Cosmic sound is nothing but Omkara. It's called cosmic sound meditation, or it's called Omkara Dhyana, or it's called Pranava Dhyana. All these three mean same thing. Cosmic sound meditation is the English name. Pranava Dhyana or Omkara Dhyana is the Sanskrit name. What is meditation? Meditation is a way of achieving silence of the mind. Mind becomes silent naturally. Okay? In that silence, you feel, you experience peace, deep peace. When the mind is silent, you experience peace. And that peace is called peace of the soul, Atmada Shanti. We tell many people that after they pass away, rest in peace. May his soul have peace. Okay, if the poor fellow didn't have peace throughout his life, how can he have peace after death? So better to have peace now rather than after death, after going through ICU and going to some other world. No, don't worry about the peace now. Then have peace, experience now. Okay, that is what is called meditation. Okay. Experience the peace when you are alive, right? After death, so many things happen. Your LIC policy will go to somebody and so many things will happen. Okay, after death, what happens, we don't know. Okay, so while alive, let us experience peace. That peace is peace of God, the peace of Bhagawan, the peace of the self, Atma. Okay, so where is the peace? Throughout the universe, if you were to, let's go into deep galaxies or stars, slightly go away from the earth. Okay, is there any noise there? No TV show, no politics, no cricket, no commentary. Okay, what is there? Silence and peace. In that silence and peace, a sound is heard. Okay, the scientists of NASA have sent a probe to the deep into the sky. When the probe goes, probe is sent there, in that probe records some sounds, and that sound is called Omkara. Om, Om. So in the deepest silence there is a sound. That sound is called Omkara. You can think that Omkara is nothing but heartbeat of God. Okay, Omkara is Bhagawan's heartbeat, like you have dak 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 dak, not the song here, dak dak song. Okay, your heart goes no dak 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 dak. Sometimes some music, some dance or whatever, dak 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 dak. Your heartbeat varies, but universe has a heartbeat. That's called Omkara. Okay, that Omkara is the primordial sound, the fundamental sound. Okay, so do you know that what is soothing for the child, very soothing, what makes child very peaceful? The child is in the womb of the mother. The only sound it hears is the duck 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 duck, the heartbeat of the mother. Okay, and throughout 9 months the child has heard that heartbeat of the mother, and the child is peaceful. So what they do is they record the heartbeat of the mother, and when the child is born, they play the recorded sound. The crying child becomes silent because it's very comfortable with the heartbeat of the mother. Okay? So now we are in this meditation, we are recreating that experience what you have. Your mother is the universe. Okay? The whole universe is our mother. We don't know how many lifetimes you are born, and after born, getting birth, we'll start crying. Only thing is you have forgotten the heartbeat of the mother, universe. That heartbeat of the universe is Omkara. So if you are able to recollect that and connect with that sound, the mind will become peaceful and silent. Is the principle clear? Understood? Okay. So every day you tune to that heartbeat of the universe. The universe is nothing but, the whole universe is made up of Shiva and Shakti, consciousness and energy. Shiva is the consciousness, energy is the Shakti. That Shakti, energy is what is universe is made up of. All this, the stone, the wall, the sky is nothing but all this, nothing but energy, this scientists say. Shiva and Shakti are the basic principles of the universe. The energy has a frequency, vibration. The fundamental vibration of the energy is called Omkara. Okay? So when you go back and tune your mind to that fundamental vibrations, the mind becomes deeply silent. And you merge your consciousness with the universal consciousness, Shakti, Shiva. So you are now Jiva, right? You are individual soul. The Jiva has to experience the universal father, Shiva, and universal mother, Shakti. Right? When you experience universal father and mother, the Jiva becomes peaceful. That's all is the principle of meditation, spirituality. Clear? What stops you from experiencing that Shiva and Shakti? First of all, you have started feeling Jiva. Okay? You have forgotten that you are Shakti. And you have forgotten that you are consciousness. Then you have become body, mind and intellect. You say, I am a body. Which you are not. Right? What you are is nothing but, at the physical level, you are energy. At the consciousness level, you are consciousness. At the deepest level, you are consciousness. So, you have to understand how to convert your body, how to make your body into energy. And that energy has to be tuned to the universal energy, Shakti. Then become silent observer, Shiva, consciousness. So that's how you merge with Shiva and Shakti. Are we clear? And that merger happens at the top of the head, Sahasrara. Why top of the head is when you are born as a child, there is a soft place at the top of the head. That soft place was open. Okay? Then as the child becomes gross, that becomes hard and closes. You feel that you are separate from the universe after that. So right now the energy, the Omkara meditation is designed for increasing energy in your body so that you can, your energy, you can feel that merger happening at the top of the head, Sahasrara, with Shiva and Shakti. Okay? So in that merger you experience that I am not the body, I am not the mind, I am not the intellect, I am consciousness, I am Shiva. Right? Nanu nanembudu nanalla. Ideha mana buddhi nanalla. Satchidanandatma Shivananu Nane Shivoham. You are divine. Okay? That experience is meditation. And meditation is a very conscious process. Awareness is there. It's not unconsciousness, it will not be there. There's awareness and silence. Understand? Shall we start?